Is your PC a little slow? I might have the perfect solution for you. If you're looking for a software that automatically optimizes your PC, cleans up your files, does overall PC protection, startup management for all those programs that want to start up alongside your PC, menu management, all-around issue scanner, I might have the perfect tool for you. Let's check it out real quick.
So we're going to be testing Auslogic's BoostSpeed 14. So we'll just click free download. And once that's done downloading, we'll just click right over here. And we can leave these defaults here unless you want to change the installation directory. And I don't like to send anonymous information, and agree and install. Now, this is stuff that you can consider later on, the Auslogic driver update, which is something I might get into a little bit later in a different video, but we're going to focus on BoostSpeed for now. So we'll just click finish here with a check under launch BoostSpeed. So it starts up with my dashboard and then opens up thanks for installing BoostSpeed. And you can enter in your information here, but I'm going to go ahead and close that. And let's go ahead and click scan under my dashboard to see what this finds. This is going to be the first time I've run it, so I'm going to be surprised by this. All right, when it's done, resolve all pops up, and this pops up on the bottom right hand corner, which is actually kind of cool. I don't like to do a resolve all before I know what it's doing, so I'll click details. Gives you how much junk it found and how much space it can save you. This is part of the pro version, so just wanted to let you know about that. Then we see here 229 stability issues. We're going to find out what that is in a second. 277 performance issues found. That's nice. And disk defrag. And you don't really defrag an SSD. You could damage it. What it surely will do is trim it, and we'll check that out in 1 second. So see report and customize. So recent document. So here it's just going over invalid shortcuts because they're part of the recent and desktop shortcut. Yeah, those actually might not be a bad thing to get rid of those. I don't know that it's going to cause a tremendous issue. Invalid help related entries. Okay, that's nice. I see that that could actually work for me as well. Now we'll do performance. File extension. Now, I'm careful with these, especially because it says registry. So you definitely want to be careful with those. Invalid extensions, empty unused registry, invalid extension. Okay. Disk defrag. Okay, so it's telling me my C drive, but the Windows directory, that's a little bit odd. It's not a bad thing to run it here. Don't run it all the time, but an occasional is not a bad thing. Privacy, cookies, cache, and all that good stuff right up here in your web browsers, and traces in applications. Oh, that's nice. So everything that you've logged into here, it's going to show you and going to get rid of it from here. So that is actually kind of nice. Back to all. A lot of them kind of scare me, but I'm going to run them on my main machine so I can let you know just how good or bad it is. Internet speed, TCP IP, WinSock, and workstation. Coming back over here. Windows tweaks, 7 here, so add control. Okay, Cortana disables Cortana, or the advertising ID inside of Cortana, geo tools, sync tools, and mouse boost. All right, so coming back to all areas, I'm gonna run it now, and we're gonna see in a little bit how that helps, and actually what I'll do. So again, the pro version will clean out 10.27 gigs or of course more on your drive. So if we click activate pro over here, it opens up this site, and that's going to be $70, and you can definitely put all that information there, send it out. I'll enter my key in a little bit. So right now I'm liking everything it's showing me. I'm a little bit iffy on the registry parts, but I'm going to go ahead and do it. And while that's scanning, it's nice to see down here, it gives you little ticks on your CPU performance, the heat, the GPU performance, the RAM, your network traffic, your hard drive or SSDs down here. So that's kind of cool. then your system information here. This is definitely a nice tool, especially if you don't know the manufacturer or model number of different devices in your machine. You'll click that and hey, what motherboard do I have? Ah, I have an MSI X670E Gaming Plus Wi-Fi. That's definitely good to have. So we'll come back here to resolving. Still working hard to get rid of everything here. And it goes through each of them as you're running these passes, you know, going from disk space to stability, performance, disk defrag, then to privacy, and I'll go through the rest. So that's kind of nice to see exactly what it's doing. So it looks like we need to restart the PC before we can keep going. So one sec. And I didn't realize now coming back after rebooting how many things are looking for my location, Filmora being one of them. So you can either open your settings and change the location being turned off or just got it. And there was a few others, but I had skipped through them. So let's keep going. I like where this is going. And I've already felt so far that my PC is a little bit smoother, which is definitely a nice thing.
As a content creator, a dad, I have a day job and everything. I don't have a whole lot of time to record and do all these edits. I gotta catch every single second I get some free quiet time. So this is going to save me a ton of time because I find myself reformatting, reinstalling Windows, drivers, updates, and programs just to save a few extra seconds all the time. I typically reformat once a year. This is going to save me some time. So I like that a lot.
Now we've done my scanner. We'll notice though that aside from what we've done already, there are, for example, disk space, stability, performance, well, looks like all of them, maybe minus disk defrag, they have the pro version as well, which we haven't run, and I do have a license. Let's go ahead and enter that license real quick. All right, enter my key. And now the program is registered. So just remember, there are a few portions that require registration. So we'll keep going. Now under My Advisor, it's going to give you different recommendations to improve your system stability, your components, your security, and your speed. Definitely a nice thing here. Cleanup, which is something we're going to go over a little bit later in a different video, the manual way. This does everything all automatic for you, and it's definitely a nice thing. So for right now, Deep Disk Cleaner. Let's go ahead and run that real quick. So here it's going to go through a lot of the cached information. One sec. After the scan, everything is going to show up here. And we can see here how much it's going to save. 2.97 gigs, that's in my recycle bin. That happens, I just got lazy. 4.24 gigs in my temporary files. Definitely it'll save a ton. And it looks like those are my two main culprits. I have a few others, but those are program specific, not Windows like this. So I'll go ahead and click cleanup. So empty folder cleaner. Now this one can be a little scary. It's going to go through every single drive and look for empty folders and then delete them all. So I'm going to leave it on the C drive for now. Scan now, one sec. All right, so it's found everything here. Now, this scares me a little bit because maybe they're not empty. So you might want to double check. We'll go in here and we'll look for that hidden folder, the WS and the BT. So going in here, well, that is empty. And in here, well, that's empty as well. Now, we can go through the rest, but that might take some time. Let's go ahead and delete. All right, that took a little over half an hour. It's incredibly thorough. I love it. So that's gonna go ahead and remove all of the empty folders from your drive. Disk Explorer, actually, this is an incredibly handy tool. I'm just going to do my main drive, my C drive. So one sec. This is incredibly useful because it tells you where all of your large files are, and that's going to help you a lot when you want to go in one by one to find files you may not need that are taking up a lot of space on your drive. So definitely good information here. You can go deep into the folders and then, you know, go into anything and manually come over here, right click and delete it if you like, or, you know, delete multiple files if you like, just like that. So that's pretty awesome. I'm not going to delete anything because I've already deleted all the empty folders and I don't want to delete those. Another useful tool over here, the Startup Manager. Here shows you everything that your PC is starting with. And actually it's a lot more than I thought it was, but that's okay. So this is for my printer, my scanner, and you know what? I don't want this one to start. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to test it real quick. I'm going to reboot my computer, see how long it takes, and then remove things from here and then see how long it takes. So 1 second. All right. So using BootRacer, I was able to tell how long it took me to get to a 100% usable state of Windows, 102 seconds. So almost 2 minutes to get into a perfectly stable mode of Windows. So from start to Windows, it was only 14 seconds to get perfectly to a desktop state that you can do whatever you want and no other pop-ups popping up, 88 seconds more. So that takes a long time. So let's go ahead, get out of here real quick, and we'll come back to that in 1 sec. So let's get rid of OneNote. I'm not sure what that one is. And if you're not sure what something is, don't delete it just yet or don't disable it just yet. Look into what it is. For example, open up a browser, cross device experience host. And then here it tells you, so that we may want to leave that if you use your Microsoft account on here. I don't use Teams, at least on my personal machine, so I'll disable that. Coming down more from here, I don't want to use the Creative Cloud, and we can disable the GitHub, and we're going to leave all of that. And I do use a Razer mouse, so I'll leave that there. Let's see, this is Discord, so let's disable that and come back over here. And I just want to make sure, so software, this is for my Brother printer, and then here it tells you what everything is or who makes that product. So we're good here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to restart. All right, so if you remember, 102 seconds, almost 103 seconds. So let's test that real quick. 1 sec. So from 102 seconds to 72 seconds, we basically shaved off. We have that time. Mind you, there's more stuff we can disable, but those are the ones I want to disable for now. Coming under task scheduler, look at all these different tasks that I didn't even realize. Background tests that are running that I didn't even realize either. And mind you, we can always come under task manager and see all that here, but this puts it all in one easy place. And I actually like that a lot. Makes things so much easier. If you notice, we're building up a bunch of different tabs inside of this, but we can just come back over here to my dashboard, the very beginning, and then just start going through everything here. Then under Optimize, we can go to Windows App Cleaner and a bunch more stuff in here that you can go through. And I've already opened up so many different tabs. So we've gone through the scanner, through the advisor, cleanup, optimization. We can do protecting as well, which looks like it's going to be a lot of what we may have already done with the cache cleaner. So that's nice, but we can scan again if we'd like.
I was able to get for all of my viewers a 20% discount. So check down into the description below for all the details.
Maintain. This is going to be a lot of what we've done already under my scanner. And it looks like rather than just doing all of them again, they're breaking it down so they make it a lot easier. If you feel like there's maybe a piece of software that you're missing because maybe you want some more features and functions. Going back to the driver software I was talking about, Auslogic Store, we can check out the driver updater, anti-malware, this defragger, which this already brings, but it does not bring a driver updater and an anti-malware. So that might be nice to check out. Then coming down here, file recovery, which definitely would be a nice thing. Video grabber, that could be a nice thing as well. A lot of nice things inside of the Auslogic store as well. And then for these tabs down here, we've already done the disk defragger, the SSD optimizer. Let me just verify. And this would be, since it is an SSD, this would be trimming. And we can always do that from here. And this is going to be part of the Windows defragger, which again, does not defrag an SSD. It only trims an SSD. So we can just click that. And the nice thing about this, rather than only trimming, it does do file rearrangement, not a traditional defrag. So don't worry about this. It's not going to mess up anything, especially if you're only going to run it once for optimization. And then you can either let Windows handle the trimming, or you can always come back in here and do additional trimming. But it's not something you want to run very often, just when you feel like you might be losing some performance on your SSD. All right, and that took a few minutes to reorganize those files and trim everything, looking all XP-like. That's kind of cool, brings me back. Then disk doctor here to see if there's any issues with any of the drivers. And you know what, I might as well go ahead and do it. Let me deselect all of these and then do a scan. 1 sec. That finished pretty quick. No errors found. Checking out the smart or SMART info. Cool. And so everything's great here. And then the uninstall manager, which, mind you, we have programs and features, but the uninstall manager should do a better job than that. It also lets us uninstall Windows features, which is actually a great thing. And then tells us which of the applications we have installed that we don't use. I can tell you this is accurate. And force uninstall. Those might be just a little bit more difficult to uninstall. So that's kind of nice. It gives you all those features.
I'm not generally one to use this kind of software. I like to do things manually, but actually playing with this software, I fell in love with it. I was able to get that discount because I fell in love with it. I reported back to Auslogic what I felt about it. But aside from that, the task scheduler, all those things to disable all your boot menus, to disable all the startup items, all of the different things the software provides, I found it amazing. I want you guys to check it out. There's the free version, but then there's also the paid version. Start off with the free version. I think you'll fall in love with it pretty quick. This is Iggy with ThisBytesForYou showing you Auslogic's BoostSpeed. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou up. See you guys.